Hey, it's Nicodemus from geepeekay.com. Been a long time since the last video, I apologize. But I thought I'd do one tonight on something that people ask me about all the time and want to see a video about, and that is cheap toys. These are a very popular part of the hobby with a select little group of collectors. Nowhere near as popular as the stickers. These came out in 86, right after the third series. They're little plastic toys made in Hong Kong and released by Topps to try to capitalize on some of the craze going over the stickers. Kind of fell off the face of the earth for 20 years, and a few years ago started to see kind of a rebirth in interest that peaked at a level of insanity with certain collectors. Now it's kind of mellowed out a little bit. A lot more has been discovered in the last few years than was ever known before. So it seems like a good time to make a video, give everyone a little overview on what they are, show them some examples, and hopefully it'll help the collectors out. So without any further ado, let's take a look at some cheap toys. And they're not cheap, by the way. So like I said before, these were released in 1986. There's actually two series of cheap toys, a Series 1 and a Series 2. The Series 1 is much more common, and you're able to find them on sites like eBay pretty regularly. The packaging is pretty standard. Came in a cardboard display box. This one's sealed, or else I'd open it up and show you. But inside it contained 24 bags. So this is an example of a cheap toy packaging. It's a green plastic bag, comes with a yellow twisty tie on it, and inside each bag was a checklist, right here, I don't know if that's focusing on it. So you got a checklist in each bag, it's a little flimsy piece of paper with all the characters on it. You got one toy, and you got a bag of candy sealed up. Just some coins, they have stupid sayings on them. But that all was crammed inside the bag, and that's why it's called Cheap Toys with Candy. It's actually crummy candy if you read the box, and that's probably accurate. But so that was all crammed in there. Couldn't tell really what one you were going to get. You can kind of tell by manipulating the bag what figure is in there. These are the 10 sculpts that are in the series. This is one of the common colors. This is the peach color. You can see the accuracy and the detail is actually pretty strong for miniature figures. A lot of detail went into them. Kind of really captured the essence of the character from the card. Underneath it here is the sales sheet that went out to distributors announcing the release and details on what's included in the set. So it's kind of an overall look at the base set of Series 1. I do have some other colors that I can show you that kind of make the hobby a little bit more interesting. So in addition to the peach, there were three other base colors or basic colors. There was a red, blue, a green, and the peach. And I just realized that I pooched it and I did not have him in with the other 10 or the other 9. But those guys plus him is all 10 sculpts. So as collectors have begun to dig into this hobby more and more, there's actually a variation of each color. There's a light green, a dark green, a pea green, there's a light blue, dark blue, light blue, light red, etc. And those are just variations of the base colors. There's actually variations all over the board that have put it over 21 colors discovered now, when there was originally thought to be 4. And the variation is not just in color, it's also in material used. And there's certain colors and certain materials that fetch much higher dollar when being sold or traded. So I will now show you a couple of the different rare color variations. Alright, so you can see here, this is just a little splashing of some of the rare colors I took out of my collection here. Just shows the wide variety that these things come in. There's actually a couple other blue ones, I just didn't feel like unpacking them. But yeah, the colors are really all over the board. You obviously got the really bright neon red orange. You got the extremely rare cinnamon color back here. That's hard as a rock and has actually little specks in the material to make it look almost like a cinnamon. You have ones from the United Kingdom that were certain material. You have ones from Canada that were certain material. You have the neon yellow. The neon colors tend to be some of the most popular. They're real rubbery. The figures bend easily. They feel pretty good in the hand, and the colors tend to be pretty dynamic and pretty popular. Usually brighter than the normal colors. Yeah, just feel really good in the hand. There's an orange here. So like I said, at first there was only thought to be four colors, and they just started popping up in random colors and mixtures, and yeah, it really caused quite a boom in the hobby. So I hope you guys enjoyed just a little peek at the cheap toys. Hope you got a little information that maybe you didn't know before, and maybe stoked your curiosity and make you want to pick up a few. You can find the common ones on eBay. I would say, a few bucks a piece. You're gonna have to spend quite a bit more to pick up some of the rarer colors, and a lot more to pick up a series too. But as always, thank you guys for watching, and thank you guys a ton for visiting my site, all the nice emails I get, and hope you guys enjoyed the video. Until next time, this is Nicodemus. Have a good night, guys.